Thank you for coming my videos, and this video I didn't plan it, but that happens, you know, sometimes it happens. Inspiration for my videos comes from absolutely unusual destinations. So my story short, this morning I went to my local supermarket, and after you pay after tills, you pay for it. They have an area like a packaging area, and they had a bin. Yes, I went in the bin, and what I saw there, I couldn't believe my eyes. All right, dun dun dun. Right. If you don't know what is it, I will tell you. It's a green topping of pineapples. And that's what you need if you want to grow one. Just for fun, just for experiment, doesn't matter. I tried it before, I wasn't successful, and I don't mind to try again. So, when you choose pineapple and you won't actually use the green part, you need to make sure the leaves in a good tugger. Check the middle. Middle should be still be there, because some growers, they pull it out just to prevent this green part from growing and keep the actual fruit, give it some more life shape, shelf life. So when you're choosing pineapple, make sure you still have a green bit middle, and it's nice and green. And of course, leaves in a good tugger. No frost damage or anything like that. So any like a brown marks or damage. So, and what you need to do, just peel all this scaly. Oh wow, we in luck, it's already good roots. Oh dear. Right, oh, I need to peel the scales off, simply because you need to put it in the water to let roots to grow a bit bigger. And another reason, because it's not in the soil, it's disconnect from a nutrition source of nutrition, so you reduce evaporation and let roots to have in a better contact with water. Plus you make minimum chance for water to get smelly. Obviously, you have to change water on a regular basis. Oh, come on. God, the first time I got this thing with already roots on. Okay. So I managed to get 5. And I think that's gonna be a good, interesting experiment for you too, to see how easy it is or how difficult it is, because you never know how it's gonna turn up. Okay. Right. Some people recommend to clear up like a halfway. I'm gonna try to do differently. Some of them gonna be halfway, some of them gonna be just a bit. So we will see how it actually works better. Okay. Yeah, there's a bit of. Okay. That's probably just, not necessarily halfway, but just quite, like probably 1 inch long. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to use my plastic containers from grapes, which I always save if I buy grapes. And I pour water in each cup. And the idea is you place your plant or fix it somehow. It stays only roots in the water. So I already done peeling, and as you can see, all five of them, they have roots on the bottom. I decided not to peel too much because, as you can see, the bottom leaves, it's a great support for whole plant to stay just to touch the water and not going too deep in the water. And I want to say that the reason why these tops got roots, more likely these pineapples, like in a warehouse or during the transplantation from tropical country to this country, they haven't been exposed to any frozen below zero temperatures. So that's the reason why they are in such a good condition. So just a little advice, if you fancy to do it yourself, when you look at the pineapple in the shop, make sure it's as healthy as possible. The leaves are in a nice tuber, and the middle of green part is still there. There's no frost marks, no any mold or anything like that. So the healthier your original fruit is and topping, the more successful you can be. Right. So I promise I'm gonna keep you posted and will tell you progress, how's it doing. And I'm gonna do some homework as well to find out what sort of soil is the best to plant them in. Thank you for watching. I'm very excited, I know. But anyway, thank you for watching, and see you soon. Bye.